Guys, I'm coming back with a huge giveaway right now. This account has tons of money, mod outfits, and all that good stuff. This giveaway is 100% real. All you have to do is follow 4 steps. Subscribe to me, like this video, and be active on this channel. Also, comment down below your console, PlayStation, or Xbox One. The link will be down in the description below to enter the giveaway. This giveaway is 100% real. So, I wish y'all all luck. Peace. Yo, how's it going, guys? Squishy here, back with another video today. And in today's video, I'll be showing you guys how to make the best modded outfit on GTA 5 online on the latest patch of 1.50. So make sure you go smash the like button and to subscribe for more videos like this. And do not forget to enter the biggest mod account giveaway that I am hosting right now. So let's get straight in today's video. All you have to do is push your pause button, go to online, and go to your female character. Now by doing that, all you're gonna have to do is push swap character. So once you have finally gotten to this part, as you see, you should have a female character for this glitch. This is what you mainly need for this glitch. So all you have to do is select your female character. So I'll be back with you guys once I've entered a random session. All you're gonna have to do is go to any clothing store on the map. So I'll be back with you guys once I've gotten to a clothing store. Is copy the two components that I make right now. Now the first one, go to browse tops, and all you're gonna have to do is go all the way down to tuck t-shirts. Now once you have gone to tuck t-shirts, as you can see, number 11, the black classic tuck t-shirt. Now all you're gonna have to do is equip that, and after you have done that, go all the way down to denim jackets. Now once you have gotten to denim jackets, all you're gonna have to do is pick number 9, the distressed denim jacket, as you see right here. So once you have equipped that, go to browse pants. Then once you have done that, go all the way down, or go down to sports pants and pick the spotted muscle pants, as you can see number 1 right here. Now once you have finally equipped that, go to shoes, go to brass shoes, go to boots, and pick the chocolate select boots number 33, or sometimes for other people it can be number 31. Just make sure that the chocolate select boots. Then once you have done that, you're gonna go all the way to accessories and go to gloves, as you can see what I do right here. Now it's gonna be number 4, the light woolen tactical gloves number 4. Now once you have equipped all that, now you have just made your first component. Now as you see, I am aiming these 1 and 2, okay, just to let y'all know. Now once you have done that, now it's time to create your second component. Now for the second component, all you're gonna have to do is go to browse tops, go all the way down to party tank tops. Once I've gone to party tank tops, as you can see, the leopard loose tank number 1. Now once you have equipped that, all you're gonna have to do is go up to tactical jackets. Now once I've gone to tactical jackets, go all the way down to number 79, the last one, the khaki tactical blue suit. Now once you have equipped that, as you can see, you already have your woolen tactical gloves and your sports pants, as you see, the spotted muscle pants with the same chocolate slack boots. All you're changing for this is the tank top and the jacket. That's all you're doing for the second component. Then once you have created your second component, now you can save it to your second slot. Or on the bottom of your first component. Now once you have finally done all that, all you have to do is pick outfit standard and put on this standard outfit, as you can see right here. Now by doing that, this is making sure the glitch doesn't mess up or anything like that. Components that I have showed you to do. Now all you have to do is do the transfer glitch. I'll leave a link down below in the description of the transfer glitch. All you have to do is push your pause button, go to online, and push creator mode. So once you have finally gotten to the creator mode menu, all you have to do is push create a race. Now, you're going to be creating a land race. So once you have done this, go to race details and fill in the title. You can put anything in the title, it does not matter at all. Just make sure you do put something that you would remember. Then for photo, you can take any photo you want, does not matter at all. Now once you have done that, all you have to do is go to route type and put that to point to point. That's all you have to do, does not matter at all. Then once you have done that, all you have to do is back out of that, go to placement, push place trigger, and you can place that anywhere you want. Now once you have done that, back out, go to the lobby camera and take any picture that you do want. Does not matter at all. Then once you have done that, go to checkpoints. Now the maximum players, the best is to put the maximum players to 2, just because it's more faster and all that. So put that to 2. Then once you have done that, you're gonna make a race that is over 0.60 miles long. So I'll be back with you guys once I've done that real quick. So once you have finally created a race over 0.62 miles, all you have to do is test the race. So I'll be back with you guys once I finally tested the race. So once you have finally completed the race, all you have to do is push OK. Now, once you have completed the race the first time, all you have to do is push save. Do not push publish, push save. Now once you have finally saved it, push OK. Now for this part, all you have to do is test it one last time. So I'll finally be back with you guys once I have tested this one last time. So once you have finally completed the race one last time, all you have to do quickly is push OK. Then once you have pushed OK, all you have to do is push pause and go all the way to the right to online and push choose character. Now once you have finally gotten to this point, all you have to do is delete your female character. Do not delete your male character, make sure that you do delete your female character. So once you have successfully deleted your female character, All you're gonna have to do is push circle to go back, and that should load you into story mode. So I'll be back with you guys once I have went into story mode. Please is push your pause button, go to online, go to play GTA Online, and go to a gold session. So I'll be back with you guys once I am in a random session. Once you have arrived to a random session, all you're gonna have to do is check if you do have your components and see if they transferred. So by doing that, go to your interaction menu, go to style, and as you can see, component 1 and component 2 has transferred onto my male character. And as you can see, this outfit is the one I am wearing right now. Just saying that by doing this glitch, all your outfits do delete by doing this glitch. So right now, all you're gonna have to do is go to your house. So I'll be back with you guys once I have done that. So once you have gotten to your apartment or house, all you're gonna have to do is push right to change clothes. Now once you have done that, all you're gonna have to do is go to Tops and put on the racing jersey. Now once you have gone to racing jerseys, now in my suggestion, I prefer this one because it does match the vest and all that. As you can see, the gloves are orange, and that's why we are putting this outfit or jersey on for the racing gloves. So once you have done that, all you have to do is take off any accessories. So once you have done that, all you have to do is go to the mission called Crooked Cop. Now by doing that, go to online, jobs, play job, Rockstar created, and go to versus. Now as you can see, if you go to the bottom, the job Crooked Cop is right there. Now you could do this job with any random person, or it could be a friend. Just make sure that they do have settings on player owned outfits, so you can switch your components and all that. So I'll be back with you guys once this job has started. About to start. So once you have gotten to this part, all you have to do is go to owned outfit and go right once and right again. Now as you can see, you do have the orange vest and the orange gloves with the white joggers and with the invisible torso. So once you have done that, all you have to do is ready up. So I'll be back with you guys once I'm actually straight into the mission. So once you have finally gotten to this point, all you're gonna have to do is put any accessory on. Now what I mean by that, you can put any mask, any helmet, or anything like that. Go to accessories in your interaction menu, and you can put on any mask, as you see what I do right now. Now once I have done that, pick up your phone and quit this mission from your phone. Now by doing this, this is gonna put you into a random session. So I'll be back with you guys once I am in that session. Peace. Well, once you have gotten to a random session, as you can see, I do have the modded outfit with the invisible torso, trash man vest, and especially with the white joggers. Now once you have gotten your modded outfit, now you can save this outfit in the ammunition store, the clothing store, or your apartment. But this is how you get the modded outfit on GTA 5 online on the latest patch of 1.50. So make sure to smash the like button and to subscribe for more videos like this. And believe me, I am on the grind and all that good stuff. And do not forget to enter the mod account giveaway that I am hosting. The link will be down in the description below. Make sure to enter that. It's going to be a huge giveaway on this channel. So this is Skull HD. I'm signing out. Peace.